This is a best of three, by the way, so don't turn off the stream if you see one team win or one team lose. It is a best of three, so that's obviously up to a three games, down to a 2-1. Morgana ban going out. Fairly common ban for any high elo team across the world. Morgana is super strong, laning phase, great in team fights. Generally an annoying champion, so it's quite common to see her banned. Then we got Twist of Fate going out. I know GG's been playing a lot of Twist of Fate as of late, and he's been really good with him, and just the global ganks and stuff like that. The stuff you can do in competitive play with TF is really good, and it's just really good. That's about it. Global ganks are really strong if used correctly. And he's back. I need like an energy drink. Get pepped up. Get all fired up for this game. Some enthusiastic casting. Cannon ban going out, as we talked about earlier. Cannon, really strong middle. Doesn't need blue buff. Great AoE ulties. Great laning phase. Overall, fan-diddly-astic champion.
Okay. Guess what I'm drinking? I'll give you 20 bucks, but if you're wrong, then I get 20 bucks.
No, I refuse. Unless I get like 60 bucks, unless I get. And how will I ever know if I get it right or not? Because I can't actually see the cup.
I don't lie.
I don't trust you.
No,
You're not getting those 20 bucks. It's mine.
I seriously.
Seriously, that sounds like the awful play for me. I have to guess.
Okay,
It's
just
like,
guess
oh, just a
anyway.
little
Just
fair.
guess anyway.
I don't know. Jack and Coke.
DC Rona on the rocks.
Oh, snap. I was actually thinking that. I don't have any decent at my buddy's house. I don't have any.
So, what do you think
Secondly,
of these bans and picks?
pretty standard. TF for GG, Nidalee for Hotshot, and Shen for just Shen's pretty good. Hotshot's been playing a lot of Shen, and Sein's been known to jungle Shen, so it's pretty obvious bans. Janna being banned is just like most popular support right now, so obviously you can see your ban. And I talked about the Kennen and Morgana bans; they're just common high elo bans, anyways. But be right back while I grab a drink now.
Looks like okay. Let's see. All right, so looks like the bans from TGF are Nidalee, TF, and Shen. Been seeing a lot of those kind of global team comps lately, and Nidalee is obviously targeted ban for Hotshot. Kind of makes it very hard for them to execute on their poke comp that they love running. We've got to pick up a Corki here. Corki very strong, as I mentioned earlier. I think he's one of the better ADs in the game. So, and we got Soraka Urgot being picked up. Very, very, very strong pickup from TGF. EU meta, Urgot's highly coveted, as well as Soraka. She's kind of permabanned in EU. She's kind of seen as the most overpowered champion in the game. So very strong there. And what's really good about Soraka Urgot is that there's a lot of sustain. She provides mana to Urgot, and he can just spam his abilities. And in addition to that, She gets free silences that don't cost mana to harass as well. So it's very strong. We've got Saint picking up Shiv and Ter
Oh,
oh,
last pick, Cassiopeia.
Cassiopeia.
Juked it
That's
out.
really interesting because he's really been playing a lot of Ahri lately.
He's been playing a lot of Ahri and a lot of TF. But Cass is still strong. I don't people just like stop playing Cass for some reason. They're like, oh man, like I don't know why. She's her DPS is still like disgusting.
I think she's a little bit vulnerable to ganks than some of the other AP champions that have a
She is.
built-in escape. So, taking a strong ganking jungler can really counter Cass. I think that's the only way you can really counter Cass. I don't think there's
Yeah.
like a strong counter in lane.
I don't think anything beats her in lane.
Yeah.
Except maybe Lulu.
Maybe. I
I think
haven't
Lulu
seen it.
beats. I think I. Lulu's. When I was playing Lulu, Cass is the only one who's given me a little bit of trouble. As soon as you get your first blue buff, though, it's pretty much over.
Yeah. And you got to pick up a Udyr, and whew, Lulu. Looks like a Dignitas comp to me.
Let's check this out. Heal and three shields already. I like their comp. Shields, 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 shields. Maybe I should make this drink alcoholic. I might have to cab. Anyways.
Oh man, I'm a little hungry.
I am not. It's not a lot to eat. Actually, no, I'm just not hungry. I passed
Ooh,
Vilia.
Yorick and Leona.
It's actually the Yorick and Cassiopeia is very strong, and Corki and Shyvana. All three of those are just like hyper carries. When they get fed, they can do disgusting damage. And the Yorick just ults, they come back again for 10 seconds, full HP, full everything, and they can just go man mode on people. So I like that a lot. The CLG's got a nice team comp here, and with the Leona pick, that's got a lot of initiation. They have great initiation. Cass can counter or combo rather with it really well. Shyvana can jump right in, and their damage output is actually insanely high. We see TGF more of a passive survivability poke out and just.
I think they need a really good poker here.
Yeah. Wouldn't be surprised if we saw someone like maybe like
Heimerdinger.
a Vlad. I could see Vlad being picked here. What are oh Graves. So interesting. I thought they already had that, but I think Urgot's actually gonna be.
Mid lane?
Yeah, it could be Lulu top or your jungle. Or is this.
Urgot jungle? No.
Oh, no, yeah. It's scaring me. I'm like, what's going on? Yeah, but it's definitely. That's Urgot middle lane for sure. That's going to be Udyr jungle. And then we got Lulu top lane, I'm assuming. Or actually, Urgot. I don't know. I really don't see Urgot going top because, for obvious reasons, Lulu has tons of mobility, shields, and poke. Probably going to be a Lulu top. So. This will be interesting. I don't know how Lulu does versus Yorick. I think Lulu will actually get crapped on by Yorick. What do you think?
I think who's going top lane? Lulu?
I think Lulu's going top because I don't see Urgot going top.
I think Lulu's gonna get poo-pooed on.
Poo-pooed on.
Poo-poo.
That's dirty talk. Don't do that. Smooth, DiCerono on the rock.
DiCerono on the rocks. I always think of those commercials where they have DiCerono.
There's like they're like in some high class hotel, just like walking
Yeah,
around.
and they're pouring the
And
DiCerono
he's
on
like,
the
yeah, it's like
three
nice and
cubes of
slow.
ice.
Yeah. And like the most perfect ice cubes you've ever seen.
Yeah, I know. And this guy got the close up and it looks so
Yeah.
crisp. Yeah.
The slow motion. Slow motion makes
They're
everything.
all like really hot and they're in some like cool posh bar. It's
Yeah.
like Disaronno on the rocks.
Guy walks up, DiSerrano on the rocks. Everyone's like, ooh.
Ooh.
What did he say?
So classy.
Okay. Well, stop focusing on our drinks and
Oh,
I don't know,
shoot.
who do you think's gonna win? I think,
I think.
you know what, I'm gonna have to go TGF.
Really?
Yep.
I don't.
I'm taking underdogs here.
Okay, that's. Yeah, I was wondering why you said that. But I. You know.
I do like their comp though. I really do.
I just feel like they're lacking damage.
I think.
Like bursty damage, you know what I mean? Like, I just don't
Yeah.
think they.
The thing about that is though, they have tons of sustain. Udyr can sustain, and he's a shield. Lulu, if she gets, I'm assuming she's gonna get a Will of the Ancients because I don't know. I've seen it on a lot of Lulus when they go top. It's really good, and she can have sustain through there. And then she has the shields, the mobility, the CC. She has lots of that kind of stuff. Graves again has the ability to burst pretty dang hard for AD carry. I'd say he's got one of the highest bursts for AD carries, if not the highest burst. I think MF might trump him out, but that's not really burst with the ulti. Urgot, great poke, can swap, can pull in. Great survivability with that too. Soraka even adding more survivability. It's really like an all-in fight. Like CLG's like go, 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 go with Leona and Shyvana and Cassiopeia, and TGF's more like, we'll wait it out, we'll poke you down, we'll survive, we'll come back. And it's like, and if it gets into a point where TGF is like poking, and they have tons of poke, they have Graves that can poke, they have Urgot that can poke, they have Lulu that can poke. They have a decent amount of poke. And really the only thing that they actually both teams, Cass and Corki and Yorick, all a decent poke too. But I don't know, I think if it gets into like a poke battle and CLG just takes a little bit too much damage, TGF will come up on top because they have just clearly better survivability, like just like way more survivability. Like it's no survivability versus, you know, tons.
Well, the thing is that you're running like Lulu and Soraka. If they fight, disengage, fight, disengage, fight, disengage, then they will win that battle. Like when it gets to late game and you're basically going on wards and you know, recalling means sacrificing Baron or towers, that's where the Lulu Soraka comp is going to be more valuable. But I think damage output, team fights, I think you know, CLG is going to have to take the cake there, but
Yeah. Also, I mean, if it comes up to a straight team fight, CLG without a doubt will win, I think. But it depends. It really depends on how much disengage they have, and they have a decent disengage.
yeah.
I mean, Lulu's Q is like, I'd say one of the best disengages in the game, just because it's 80% slow. I think at max it's 2 seconds for 80% slow. That's like Nunu E-ing your entire team for 2 seconds. It's gross.
And come to think of it, you know, running Graves, at least they got some burst there. You know, they didn't take another AD carry like Vayne, which is a great AD carry, but from my perspective, they lack the burst. But now that they have Graves, it, you know, it helps a little bit. So here at level one, you just see CLG going in. They have been
Waiting for
loving this,
summoners
where
to
they just go and
begin.
camp in this brush. They just they seem to do it almost every game now. They meet here and they camp in this lower brush.
Well, actually, a couple teams have been doing that. We've actually started to do that a little bit too. We liked it. It's a good invading spot, and I think a lot of teams have picked up on that. And they're just out of the shroud of vision here. Udyr is going to be able to spot that though. So CLG has been seen. They're still advancing though.
30 seconds until minions spawn.
CLG is going to take the blue area. TGF still standing guard, waiting for them to. They're trying to bait this, and we'll see if CLG runs into this. I'm not sure if they want to go in this one or not. They're going to start poking that. Urgot's going to stand that. Graves is going to start poking that out, but not really doing anything. Nothing's going to see it. CLG deciding to actually back off a little bit. CLG pinging actually their red side, but they do actually have it warded, so TGF will know if CLG goes over there.
Yep.
Minions have spawned.
See, if I was TGF, I'd have the ADs take Wraiths here, and then just give blue to Udyr.
Yeah, COG's gonna take that advantage by going in there. Lulu.
Oh, what is she doing? Oh my
god. Here. Foster is gonna initiate with that. The exhaust going on, he has me blow a flash. So that's a summoner spell for a summoner spell. And they are fully aware that the red's being taken, so I'm curious to see if Udyr will run and try to take their red. And they're actually giving the red to Hotshot, are they? Or is he just holding that for Saint? Yeah, he's just holding it for Saint. Saint is going to pick up that red. Leona actually possibly waiting around for a gank. Yep, she is. Saint is going to come up there with Hotshot. Chester waiting a little bit. Yeah, Saint. Almost went a little bit too soon there.
I think they're going to get this. I mean, they've got red. They've got Chester stun.
They know he doesn't have flash is the thing.
Yeah.
Oh, and they're... Nope, it's definitely not going to happen, I don't think. Actually, never mind. The damage coming out from Saint Vicious is just too much to handle. He didn't run just straight back. He kind of tried to juke it. I think if he just tried to run straight back into tower, he would have made it. But that is a nice pickup for Saint, for CLG. Saint picking up that first blood. We all know Shyvana does some disgusting damage early game, and we just saw it.
Yeah, that's just really smart play. You know, they know what caused that wasn't Lulu overextending top. In my opinion, it was Lulu's decision to go through that area in jungle and having to waste flash. I mean, we saw that at DreamHack, and I think everybody, when Doublelift did that, you just don't go that way.
Well, I think he might have got baited by the fact that they have a pink ward, or not a pink ward, rather just a ward in their own red. So he figured, I don't see them. Maybe it's fine. He just probably assumed that it was fine, and they were just out of the ward range, so they actually didn't see them in there.
Yeah.
But you're definitely right about that. You should never, ever, ever. Competitive tip of the day. Always run around the back. You can miss a couple CS because it's not worth blowing a summer spell and then giving up first blood.
Yep. So what do you think about this matchup bottom here? You know, Corki Leona, which is a super bursty, massive, high damage combo. I mean,
I think that's one of the best bursts bottom lane for any bot lane comp. Missing the E there. Chester taking, or rather Double taking lots of damage, but Pinku gonna take tons of damage too. Chester getting really low. But you like that guy's name, don't you?
Let's
Liquidity.
See. Oh, it doesn't tell me how much armor Chester's running.
Chester has... He's got... 46 armor right now, so he probably has full armor, and he's probably got reds, yellows, and then probably MR blues. Assuming. But actually, we see the swap up with Urgot actually top lane here.
You know, Urgot is just a really strong solo laner. Some would say that he's one of the best solo lane champions in the game.
Yeah, that's when they started, but we have Shyvana here coming up the backside, but they actually see him. They're going to disengage with that smoke screen. Chester are unable to get anything off, just a little bit too far out of range. Big Fat taking some damage harassed from that Lulu. We possibly have Udyr here coming in from the side. Maybe we'll see a gank here on Big Fat.
No mana.
And there it is. Here it is coming in middle. Blowing the flash out of him. And they are going to actually have to back up for that.
See, in a good jungler here will, you know, remember that there's no flash on mid and be likely to regank.
And Urgot's actually getting dominated top lane. I almost think the TGF should have changed their strategy from what they were trying to do with the Lulu top and the Urgot middle. And just actually picked a top lane that could counter Yorick, because they were actually last week. They could have picked a Nasus. They could have picked a couple other champions that can counter Yorick. So I'm kind of surprised at that. I guess they were stuck on a comp, and they were like, hey, whatever, we're in this deep. Let's see what happens.
Mm-hmm. York is just super strong, you know, and as soon as he gets items and he's got his man immune and, you know, if he goes Wurmogs and he's just super tanky, he's got high AD and he just doesn't die, and then, you know, and then he's ulting the carry.
We do have Saint and Big Fat waiting in the jungle here, but looks like Koala is aware of that, so he's going to back out.
You know, usually blue spawns around 7:15. Oh, there we go.
Yeah, there it is. They're going to take that blue, though. They had it timed way better than TGF did there. So TGF, I don't think they have an idea that it's even gone. We noticed that CLG actually has three wards here, and Sorok is going to face check with the Udyr here. Pinku taking tons of damage, actually isn't going to drop though. Exhaust being blown on the Udyr. Will Saint have enough damage to take him out? Yorick is going to come here and start slowing them. Lu's going to help try to shield that. Udyr's going to blow a shield, and actually, yeah, are they going to dive? No, he's actually going to get away. Lulu is completely though, so they can't really do anything. They're going to lose that blue buff and probably Dragon off this too. We see here that Urgot is coming down from the top lane. They're actually not going to, they're deciding not to Dragon.
You know, I think if Big Fat LP had ulted a little bit earlier, because as soon as Soraka turned her back on that ultimate, it just slowed instead of turning her into stone.
Yeah. Well, that's, it's sometimes that does happen. I don't think that's any really fault of him. He was trying to wait for the best possible phase check, I think, and he just so happened to turn. Ooh, Pinku taking tons of damage. Ignite being blown out. Double Lift is going to dive into the tower, but he's actually going to go down with it. That's Pinku doesn't go down. Double Lift dives tower and dies. Wow. Lucky. Great play by Pinku there. I mean, that's a little bit of luck, but he also managed to survive that. And Saint Vicious here is going to actually pick up a kill on Liquidity. You're going to blow Flash, but he actually does take out Chaucer too, so that is 2-for-1. Great play bottom lane.
Wow. I want to say, when I clicked on Soraka about, I don't know, 5-4 seconds after that happened, she was at 11 HP. So, my guess, she got down to about 5.
She was real low.
She was
real
low.
Real low.
Really low.
Hotshot here, starting the blue. Probably going to give that to Big Fat again. We have Koala here, kind of camping it out. Waiting to see where that jungler is, but unfortunately, actually going to give it to Hotshot. Hotshot is going to take the blue.
Well, what's good about that is he's going to let him build up those stacks on his tier as fast as possible.
Yeah, Manimune rushing on a Yorick is very common to see, and it's very good.
It's really good. It's really good. Actually, what's the max AD that you get when in the main
I don't actually know. I think it's somewhere around maybe 60 or 70.
I don't want to say it's 80. I want to say it's as high as 80. Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. No, that can't be the case.
No, it's. I think it's like 60. I think.
Does anybody on the stream know how much attack damage you get from Manimune when it's fully stacked? Question of the day. We'll give you a free Dodo key if you know.
I got a Ryan Asa skin right here. I got lots, actually. Oh, Liquidity blown Flash randomly. Misclick, that's unfortunate. Unfortunately, we noticed that. I hate when that happens. Oh well, though.
It looks like it's 75. That's really strong.
Good.
That's really good.
Oh,
yeah, double up coming in here. You got the Shyvana. Oh, you got Shyvana. Oh my god, that damage. Oh
yeah.
My god.
Shyvana is nasty when it comes to DPS. She's like unmatched in the forest when it comes to DPS.
It's just insane. And the thing is that you've got double armor shred because you've got Corki with his thingy, and then you've got Gatling gun, and then you've got Shyvana with her fire breathing stuff, and that's just shredding like crazy.
Yeah, that's, I think Shyvana's is percentage and Corki's is flat, so that really scales well together. And yeah, we see TGF getting a little bit behind here. They're only 3k behind. That's not so much, but they are a little bit not in the best of shape early game. It is only 3-2 and 1 dragon, but We have to see until some team fights break out and how well they're gonna do in this laning phase.
Yeah. Wow. See, the thing is they're gonna be dropping armor so much on the targets, and then Yorick the whole time is just gonna be spamming with his ghouls and auto attacks. And my guess is that after he gets this man immune, he's going to go Warmogs. That would be my guess.
It's actually not bad on him. It's Spirit Visage.
Oh, Spirit
Visage. I see a lot of Yorick's pick up a Spirit Visage. Works all with all his ghouls and all that stuff. They give him a lot of HP back, and works with his E, which is a direct HP back. Also gives him a little CDR, which is also really good on him, too.
Ooh, Ignite going down on
a lot of damage. Oh, he unfortunately missed that E. If he had landed that hotshot, would have been in some deep trouble there. But we do have a team fight breaking out over here. Blue, actually, never mind. Saint's just actually in there. My mistake. I thought they were engaging that on the mini-map.
Well, Saint,
they're just waiting
Saint's
here.
Just...
Saint just going a little bit man mode here, going dragon form right onto that Lulu. We have Cassiopeia coming around the back, dishing out tons of damage onto Aqualia. Exhaust is going up.
That knock up was so good.
The Cassiopeia can't land a good ulti, so they're gonna have to disengage. Blowing a lot of stuff for that and coming out shorthanded.
That knockup just saved them. They would have died.
Yeah, that's not, that's what I love about Lulu is where you can E and R somebody when you have like 500 AP, which really isn't, you know, so unheard of as an AP carry. When you have that, you can shield for like something disgusting. Like I think it's like 1200 or so damage when you ulti and you E somebody. Like that's a lot. That's like a 1200 heal. Like, move over Soraka. We got a new support in town, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And the knockup, too. The knockup is just so fantastic. I mean, what I love about Lulu is you can E2 stuff. So if, like, you E them, you save them, and you knock them up, and you can just Q from them.
Yep. Well, she has basically... She has a slow. She has a knockup. She has a speed. She has a disable. She has an AoE slow. And she has good scaling because she was built as a support. So...
yeah.
I mean, she's... She's, in my opinion, a little broken at the moment, but I don't know.
I agree.
We just haven't seen many games where she has, you know, kind of carried like your traditional AP carry, you know.
Yeah, I think she might be more of a solo queue stomper than a truly powerful competitive pick, because there are a lot of, you know, these hyper carries like Cassiopeia, Ryze, Morgana, Kennen, all these champions who just add so much to everything, you know. And Lulu is definitely up there with them, but maybe she's just not as viable in competitive play than she is in solo queue. Because solo queue, that champion just stomps high elo. She's always banned and picked in every single high elo game. So CLG's slightly advancing their lead by another 500-ish or so gold. Still very close game, though. It's really anybody's game. We have yet to see a team fight, and we're maybe going to see TGF here. Oh, they see that Saint is going to get caught here. He's going to get that up. The ulti going to go up, but he's going to Dragon Form ulti. The Lulu ulti, full ulti alert, but the Cassiopeia ulti going out, actually going to make them turn around. And that's an ult for ult. Actually, two ults for one ult there.
You can see
and then the Ignite was blown as well for Lulu, so Summoner Spell and two ulties.
So you've got Cassiopeia maxing Twin Fang. You've got Lulu maxing Glitter Lance. And Saints maxing Burnout.
Yeah, that's pretty standard. Mm-hmm. Ergot is coming in here. He's going to flash out of range, though. Cass,
he gets it!
There it is coming out.
You are dead, Cass.
Is going to go out. That is going to be a kill. That is a great gank by Kyun. Is that how you say his name? Kyun? That's what I'm going to call him. Great play by TGF there. Was just out of range, but actually managed to catch up. We do have a little bit going on here bottom, though. Pinku's going to take a lot of damage, but Dublin's going to go down. Doesn't matter. Actually, Dublin did go down, but now he's going to go down. Chouster is able to pick that up and keep him alive for just a little bit, but will he be able to get away? He's going to pop that shield. He's going to stun him. Look what he's doing. Tons of damage, though. I don't think he's going to have enough to dive that tower, though. He's going to take a lot of damage, and he's going to force this in right now, and that could be going to do a lot of damage to that tower.
Wow, that coordination on mid, you know, where Lulu understood that Urgot was a little bit out of range with his ult, so she sped him up, and then he got the switch, and from then, it was just too much damage. Cass couldn't handle it, and she went down.
TGF is actually going to pick up this dragon.
Lots
here.
Of damage going up top lane, and Hotshot gives the ignite down and then just comes in for the auto attack.
Yeah, I don't think, as we talked about, that's why Urgot, I was like, definitely Urgot's not going to go top lane because he just can't do it. But Lulu did have tons of trouble versus him too, so they really need to get out of this laning phase and just have Urgot be farming up somewhere because he's really, kind of into... I don't know what the word is, but he's just, you know, not be able to get any farm, and he's really just having, he's just struggling to keep himself in the game versus that Yorick. I almost think that he should be throwing Graves top lane as he's got a little bit more survivability, can disengage a little bit better, and can burst down waves a lot better than Urgot can.
Yeah, I mean, Urgot is, I went and played a solo queue game today, and I played against, a Yorick, and the damage is just in the sustain, and... Mm-hmm. You know, he just heals off the creeps, and there's only a handful of champions that counter him, and Urgot is definitely not one of them.
No. Definitely not a champion that counters him. Looking at Urgot's farm, though, he actually picked up the Philostone here. He realizes that he's going to be a little bit behind. He's picking up a gold per 10, but he is actually 50 CS down, which is a big deal, unfortunately. But there is Graves is 3-1 though, picking up a lot of farm here. Double F to slightly ahead in farm, but he has owned too. Game is still very close. It's the COG is taking slight advantage now. They're just 4K ahead. You know, in the last 8 or so minutes, they've advanced their lead by another 1,000 gold, which really isn't too much. But we still have yet to see a 5-on-5 team fight, and I think that's really where this game's going to be determined.
I just noticed that they have a player named Liquidity.
I said that. I was like, I bet you like the Graves bot lane, Liquidity. You're like, derp, derp, I'm drinking Toronto.
I just missed out on that completely. I just didn't know that there was another Liquid in the game. Why did you take my name?
I mean, I got mad at everybody who has an element in their name now.
It's like I own the
name. I was first,
Liquid.
Okay?
Well, it's funny because every time I see Reginald, he always calls me Liquidity. middle lane here, they're just going to be pushing tower. CLG is going to pick this up uncontested. And they're going to be moving up into top jungle, for top TGF jungle. Some pings going down. And it looks like, did they time this? Oh no. Oh my gosh, they did. That's really good. It's impressive. Yeah.
That's the second time CLG's done that. They did it with their blue earlier, and now they do it with the red. TGF just losing all jungle control, it seems here. Yorick is just pushing in bottom, but they did swap with putting Urgot down there again, which is definitely the wrong move, in my opinion, to make.
We got
here.
A gank coming in, though, from oh my gosh. Udyr.
So many similar names. All these Y, U's, and yep. Q's, and P's, and...
Oh my! See, you look at that. York's just taking no damage. Look at that. Just nothing. Yeah. He just heals.
He doesn't even have any armor. He has no armor. He's only got 84 armor. And you know York. Wow! I did it now. Urgot is known for armor shredding too. With the E, he just really chunks it when you land on it. So it's, you know.
Wow. I think we better start playing York. I think he's a little broken at the moment.
No, well, he does have the counter. He's more of like a exactly what CLG did, which is like their last, very last pick, and they picked up Yorick. It's because he, there's a time and a place for him, but when you get that time and that place, he's definitely one of the most difficult champions to play against.
Yeah. I mean, he was literally zoning. What's the CS? 180.
Out here, gonna blow the flash, but Chester is gonna land that. He's gonna combo with that. Ultimate going out there, and he is gonna drop down. Hotshot picking up that kill with the ignite.
So you've got Yorick's 183 compared to Urgot's 125. Turned him into a bunny. And top lane, you got Double F being super aggressive and Valkyrieing in, dodging the Q from Liquidity, and then they pick him up, and Soraka is just not going to
go down.
Yeah.
So that is a one for one. But pinging the Baron here, I believe that TFG knows where they're going for. Sane is going to Dragonform in to get that increased damage. They didn't have a ward on it, so they know this is happening. This could be dangerous to CLG, because if TGF is able to steal this, they're going to be in a terrible position where TGF can come back, can take all these towers. But they are actually going to have to back off because they won't be able to finish it. TGF won't decide to actually
now,
take
you,
that anyway.
Did you see what happened bottom? Because Yorick died.
Yep.
How'd that happen? Did you see it?
No. I just saw him fighting it out with them. I think it was just a one-for-one Soraka for him.
You got CLG, you know, just keeping the map control. You'll see only one ward here from TGF. Never mind.
Never mind.
That's what I like about Shiv, is that she has that twin bite, so she like picks up wards in two hits.
Really quickly.
Yeah.
That looks cool too.
Yeah.
Spam bam. This ain't gonna throw that ward out. Ping and Dragon, though, I don't know if it's this, if it should be even worried about at this point. I think, you know, we see CLG really trying to force that Baron area because they want to force a fight here. They are going to get started, though. TGF doesn't know that they're doing it, and they're doing it so fast. Cassiopeia with the blues is taking that down with Shyvana damage. Hotshot in there just tanking it, and that is dropping incredibly fast. TGF has no idea this is going on. That's going to be an absolutely free Baron. I don't know why they did that. They know they just cleared it. They knew they... I thought it was obvious that they were gonna, you know, at least try to do it, and they just gave him a free Baron for nothing there. I don't know why they managed, they did that. Like, they clear the wards, so you gotta at least go over there and try to see what's going on. I guess maybe they were too scared to go check it out, but that is a, you know, definitely a free Baron for nothing.
Yeah. Well, they're gonna take advantage of this free Baron, and they're gonna start pushing this tower here. And as you can see, they got the. Lights out. The poke from Cassiopeia, just clearing those minion waves, and Corki. You know, I think TGF's strategy here is to just get a swap that they can burst down someone, but I don't even know if they can burst somebody down. That's the...
Not at this point. Not when they have a Baron like that. This is just going to be a free tower. Nothing they can do about it. Going to steal some wolves while we're at it. And, yeah, TGF is really just kind of... I don't know, like, that really, like, baffled me. It was obvious that they wanted to do it, and they just let them take it. They're like, well, we don't have vision anymore. Let's just give it up. So...
Oh, I like this. I like this a lot.
Sneaky, sneaky.
Little sneaksters.
Oh, there it is. Going out. Beautiful. Oh, my God. That's fantastic. Cassiopeia is going to drop down. Leonald is going to go out hitting all five of those people. Delos is going to go down, too. Tons of damage going out there. Big Fat is going to get freaked out. The image is taking everybody out there. He did get the Yorick ultimate off, so Big Fat is going to come out and do tons of damage, too. So it is actually a two-for-one trade in TGF's favor.
That was
that
great.
That smokescreen initiate. That was fantastic. If anybody's ever been in a smokescreen from Graves, you know you literally can't see anything. It's worse than a Nocturne Ultimate. All you can see is that little area. And they got smokescreen and then swapped. It was, oh my god, there's so much happening so fast, I couldn't spit that
well,
out.
Well, Cass died in like a millisecond, but yeah. You know, York was able to get the...
To get the ultimate off, yeah, and they were able to one kill. But that was a great play by TGF.
Just really smart to hide in that bush.
Yeah. That was a great play by them, actually. Yeah. I was quite impressed by that.
You know, a lot of this game, you know, a lot of people say it's just a lot of mechanics and what have you, but so much of it is strategy, positioning, teamwork, you know, moving around the map in different positions.
Well, if you notice, like, when CLG is timing the reds and the blues, like, that right there is in that wins you games. If you can outpush a middle that doesn't have blue, I mean, that's killing power right there.
Yep.
And if you don't have that, I mean, you effectively, when you lose control of your jungle, which CLG ultimately took from them in the early, as we transitioned to mid-game and almost late-game here, it's definitely what CLG controlled the map so aggressively that, you know, TGF is really at the mercy of them. And we do have CLG here, though, going to try and bait. They're going to clear that ward that they just placed, unfortunately, for that Soraka. Scouting it out, though, and Leona is going to face check this. Oh, unfortunately, she did just turn around. Managed to get a ward in there to see, so we did not face check that. That could have been another great play by TGF. We just got a lot of poke here. I'm not sure if TGF is going to be able to hold this tower.
They should be able to.
I do still have... Oh, never mind. The Baron is out now, so this is a lot closer.
Well, yeah,
though,
but Graves is going mid, so CLG knows that. They see that on the minimap, so...
They could definitely dive this. We see Chalister popping his shield up, possibly wanting to initiate here. They are going to take that. Yeah, TGF can't hold this, though, with the Graves. He went back to base. Or granted, he's rather back. He's with them now. And I think CLG knows that their blue's up, and they might just head right over to it, and I think that's exactly what they're going to do. And they might actually try to transition middle. Yeah, there we go. See, their blue buff is going to be taken.
Cass picks that blue buff up.
Let's take a look at the gold difference real quick.
So we've got 46 to 35, so...
Hotshot with currently the most gold on the team at 10,000 gold. Versus his opponent, Urgot, who's at 7,200, which is, you know, almost like a full item. Mm-hmm. Pretty much a full item difference, which does make a big difference. They're just going to take that Baron control again, going to ward that. Really, CLG's is going to be running around, making sure all the lanes are pushed. They really only have one middle tower to get out there.
Yeah.
So probably going to move to bottom and take that tower. But I'm not sure when Baron's spawning. I think it's spawning soon, so they might just stick around and ignore the bottom tower there.
Now, if it was up to me, I would say this is getting close to the point in the game where heal starts to become an issue. You know, where being able to sustain long team fights has its advantage. Mm-hmm. Long poke battles near Baron. And when Soraka gets her full, you know, her burst heal, it's a problem.
It's a lot. You can burst heal for like 1,300 or so, can't you?
Yeah. So I think if TGF waits this out, they play this sustain game, make sure they have enough wards, and they don't.
Oh, Hotshot is gonna run up here though. Try to initiate with a ghoul here. Gonna slow down. There's the surely as it's being blown, they're actually gonna get poked
Ooh,
out by
that
Urgot
glitter
there.
lance was perfect.
Yeah.
I think.
So we're talking about the disengage that they have. Just the smoke screen and glitter lance is great disengage. You really can't go through it.
Such a cool name too, Glitter Lance. Looks like
They
they're gonna
are gonna
start this. They want to fight.
Come on, TGF. TGS have to be aware. It's going down so quick. This is the second one they're just going to let them take. Why are they doing this? They know that's going to happen. That is going to be a free Baron again for CLG. Big Fat GG going to flash blow that ulti. Soraka is going to flash for the wall even though they're getting exhausted. Leona ulti actually catching everybody here.
Wow.
Oh my god, the first damage after that.
Oh my
just
god.
Incredible. That's going to be three kills. Fantastic ultimate by Chouster there, catching three players there. Just
that was
great.
Such a good Leona ult. That is. Really strong.
Oh my gosh. And that's just going to be a free inhibitor for CLG here as they extend their lead to 21,000 gold lead here. Nope.
Oh my god. That's awful sounding.
It is an awful sound. Might have to.
Yeah,
my tenants is probably
just
cooking something. Oh yeah. Might gotta switch to.
Oh my god, there's a fire.
There's a fire. The house is going down.
Do you think it's a real fire?
No. He just always. My tenant always burns everything. So it always goes off.
Wow, that's pretty fail.
Oh, there it is again.
Oh my gosh.
I'll just get on TeamSpeak for now, and then we'll see when this goes off.
Oh my gosh. You might have to mute your mic for a minute.
Come on, don't go off again. Please, oh my god. Alright.
Alright, do you want me to just finish casting until.
I'll just, how do I mute my mic?
Yeah, just mute your mic. Okay. Alright, nobody wants to hear that. That was annoying. So, yeah, you got CLG here with the dominating lead, 55k to 39k, and they're just gonna push, they're gonna control the map, they're gonna ward, they're gonna invade jungle, they're gonna steal their buffs, take advantage of that down inhibitor on mid, and they're probably gonna just slow push here on bottom. They've got Baron. Blue just spawned, you got a ping coming down from CLG, they know that. However, TGF does have that warded. They just can't do anything. If they go in on this, they will die. And, you know, I guess it's kind of inevitable, but. Alright. Ooh, Whoa, that was a kind of an odd reverie, but. And Hotshot just coming up here, hitting the tower.
Purple Team's turret has been destroyed.
They've got to back off. They know that that was not the tower to defend. I just don't see what TGF can do here. Losing that Baron was the nail in the coffin. Double lift is potted.
Nice analogy with the nail in the coffin thing.
Oh,
we have a teamfight going out here.
That
we
was
take this one.
Just a really odd decision.
I think we're good.
Okay, no more fire. You know, in my opinion, when Lulu, you know, she turned someone into a rabbit. What is that called?
Polymorph.
Polymorph. So.
Oh my god.
So she needs to hold on to that polymorph and wait for one of the carries to come in. Ooh, double lift taking massive damage. Ooh, and this polymorph to the swap. And then St. Vicious using an ult to get away, retracting with the. Urgot's just. Oh, that shield is really good. And they're disengaging here. That was just really, really strong combo from TGF. You saw the polymorph go down, the Urgot ulted that, and managed to get out without dying. They need to go in on this. They need to go in on this. It's 5 versus 2. Oh. They need to defend towers.
I don't think there's anything they can do here.
Yeah. They just can't. Towers.
Dude, fire alarm goes off. Phone's going off. Pretty sure my house is gonna get hit with like a meteor in like 2 seconds and just make a crashing noise.
Yeah. Well, I think this is inevitable.
Yeah, I'm getting ganked by noises and commentary. Ganked IRL.
Look at Saint being sneaky.
Sneaky Saint. Oh, didn't that work?
I wonder if he saw that or if he just.
Yeah, sometimes you miss it. Sometimes you're looking somewhere else.
Yeah.
Especially if you don't have your team with you, everyone can miss it. Hodge is taking a lot of damage here.
Going
walking
down.
Up, but actually,
flashing.
When I said lots of damage, I didn't mean lots of damage because he took like 1/6 of his HP and he's Yorick, so he's just going to heal that right back up.
Yeah.
But kind of unnecessary.
He just didn't
want to
get
swashed there
because he knew his team wasn't close. So
yeah. Unnecessary, but it is a take sometimes. Lots of damage going to go out on TGF Koala here, though. Saint Vicious is going to get Polymorph here. He's going to go down. He's going to pop back up, though. He'll go down. There's the Dragon Form going up. Saint's actually taking tons of damage here. He's going to get swapped back into the team right here. Big Bat flashing in to blow the ultimate. Going to catch everybody. He's also going to go down, though, too. Saint is actually still alive somehow. Kian's going to go down, too. Koala actually managing to stay alive. And Liquidity actually picking that up, blowing the flash. He's huge. He's got the Lu ult. And there's the actual Chaucer ulting can't figure out their name. Anyways, look what he's going to keep going down there, but he's actually going to picked up by Hotshot, and Doublelift's actually going to go in, dive, and that's actually going to be the ace, and that is it.
Wow. Did you notice that as soon as Urgot swapped, then Cass came in and got her ult off?
Ult
so
off on everybody, yeah.
They couldn't finish it.
Unfortunately for GG, he was actually in tower range. Yeah, dude, I couldn't think of Leona's name there. I'm like, ultimate fight. Keep going. Can't think of the name. But that was actually going to be GG. For CLG, taking game one in this best of three. Hotshot gonna take the tower and just barely survive. And that's gonna be game one going to CLG.
Good match. That was nice to watch.
Victory!
Alright, so we're gonna be going on to game two, as you know, with the Arena Gaming Invitational. The tournament is everything is a best of. Three.
Yep.
We are not doing best of one in the tournament, even in the first round, because we want the best team to win. So we're going to be moving on to round two.